Even if you have many rooms connected with cable or wire, there may still be scenarios where the existing cabling is not enough. For example, let's say you have pulled cables to some rooms on the first and second floor, but no cable to the garage or to the basement, and you have a device there which you want to connect. A possible way of connecting Ethernet devices without pulling an extra cable are these Ethernet over power or EOP adapters. They are often called Powerline adapters. They come in various sizes and flavors and have developed a lot over the last years. What they effectively do is that they provide Ethernet ports on both ends of the connection, but rather than using a dedicated Ethernet cable in between, they run the network traffic over the existing mains power lines. In order to create an Ethernet connection over the power line, you would simply plug in one of these next to your switch and connect the Ethernet port to the switch, and then connect the other one next to the device that you want to connect, for example your PC. There are just a few parameters that you need to keep in mind. First, in some countries you get one phase electricity. That means all consumers in the house are connected to the same wire leaving the house. In other countries, like for example in Germany, you will be provided with tri-phase current. And that means if your basement would be on electricity phase, let's say 1, and the switch, let's say on phase 2, then connecting both rooms will probably not work, or at best, give you a very slow connection. You would then need to connect one of the EOP devices to another room, or change the cabling of your mains power lines, or you would need to use a so-called phase coupler, which would create a connection between the three phases for high frequency signals. Second important factor is the quality and the high frequency resistance of the cable. In-house cabling is done with rigid copper wire. Extension cords use flexible braid wire, which is not so good for high frequency transmissions. So you should connect the power line adapter directly to the wall outlet rather than with an extension cord. The third factor are curved or bent cables, which would also weaken the signal. But most probably, this is out of your control unless you would want to rewire the whole house. Actually, let's go down to the lab in the basement once more and run some tests with those adapters. If you want to skip forward, the time marker is your friend. Okay guys, so let's have a look at those Ethernet over power adapters. I just recently bought some new ones because the ones I had were quite old. So hey, this will be an unboxing video. I always wanted to make a video where out of me just taking something out of a box, right? So let me take those out and put them here. So these thingies here just go into the power connector here, and they have Ethernet connectors down here. My older models only had one Ethernet connector here, and also they didn't claim to go until 1300 megabits or 1.3 gigabits. We'll see if that corresponds to the truth. Now the power connector looks different depending on where you are on this planet. It basically looks like this in most parts of Europe. So those outer clamps here are for Germany, that inner hole here is for France. Spain is the same. If you live in the UK or in a former Commonwealth country, then it's probably something like this with the two power connectors here and ground here, which is actually slightly longer. I think this thing looks... It looks big and clumsy at the first look, but it's actually full of features, full of nice features. Actually, I like it. If you live in Switzerland, it will look like this. Oh, again, earth in the middle, the two power connectors, two hot wires here, And in North America, of course, it will look like this, either with or without the ground connector here. That's the type of connector. It doesn't really matter for our video here. So this is the German connector with the two clamps here for protective ground. So what we will be doing is we will put this into the mains outlet on the wall, and I will put one of those connectors next to my switch and connect that Ethernet port with my switch, which is in my 19-inch rack. And that should then mirror, so to say, or repeat or transmit the Ethernet traffic from the switch over the mains power line. On the other side, here in my lab, I will just connect that to a mains outlet here in my lab and connect the Ethernet part of this directly to my laptop here, and then we will run a couple of tests. Let me just quickly do that. Cool, so the first thing I really want to do here is go to the network options and check on the Ethernet adapters. I go to change adapter options here. That's my Ethernet adapter. See if it is connected. It is connected, so I do have network connectivity. Just a quick check if I can actually, you know, connect to Google. I can, just need to double check that I'm not going over the Wi-Fi. I actually need to switch off the Wi-Fi so that it is a real test. Here we go. So I do have internet connection over the cable, over the mains power line. And let's double check on that. Just Google for something. Here we go. Yep, that looks okay. Here we go. We are connected to the internet and hence to the LAN, obviously. Now, the way I want to test this is I just want to quickly transfer a file from my server using maybe FileZilla or something like that, and then do the same test again over the LAN and see how the performance changes. Let me just do that. That's a 3 gigabyte file. Let's use that one. I just copy it and paste it here on the desktop, and then we'll see what we get. So we do get roughly 10 megabytes per second. That's 100 megabit. Not too bad. Absolutely not too bad, but obviously far away from the 1 gigabit connection that is promised to us. So as you could see, I have gotten roughly 100 megabits over the power line adapter. Actually, that corresponds to what I see in the rest of the house. I know the commercials promise more, and I'm not saying that you can't get much more. All that I'm saying is, please remain realistic about your expectations. It does not mean that the device is broken or faulty if you don't get to a gigabit, for example. There are just so many influences that are partially out of our control, which make the data transmission rate in real life much lower. Let's do a quick test with a direct cable to verify the theoretical maximum that we could get. Now, in order to, let's check quickly with the hardwire directly over the switch without Ethernet over power. Let me just unplug that from the computer and plug in the directly connected cable and then do the same test. Copy that file and paste it. And as you can see, I get 10 times the speed, right? Roughly Well, yeah, now it goes down because it had been cached on the file server. But still, it's roughly like 8 or 9 times the speed. Good, so let's see if we can optimize something. Even with a direct cable, we don't really get up to a gigabit here. That's related to the nature of the test, as I'm using file transfer rather than a real network performance testing tool here. I'm just curious to see, however, if the reason why we didn't get more than 100 megabits might be caused by me being on the wrong phase. Let me switch to another outlet with one of the adapters to verify. So for the next test series, I plugged the device that is next to my switch into another power outlet because I have different electricity phases here in the house. So I just wanted to see if by chance I was on the wrong phase. Let's do the same test again. I'll paste it in here. And it's actually worse. So that's an indicator that here I'm on the wrong electricity phase. My lab down here is on 1, and the outlet next to the switch is on another. That actually tells me that that something's going wrong. I mean, that is roughly, what, 20 megabits? That is way too low. We should get to 100 at least. Or, well, yeah, 70, 80, 100 at best. Okay, let's run another test. Okay, so that was the worst case. Now let's try and get close to the best case by changing the setup again and positioning the adapters as close as possible with close to no interference in between. So for the next test, I wanted to see what would be the maximum I could get. In order to do that, I plugged in that one connector here to an extension cable and plugged the extension cable into the wall outlet, which is really next to the other. Connector here to the other Ethernet over power adapter here. Good, so we have the one here, then a couple of feet of cable, and then the other one. And I will connect one of those directly to an Ethernet connector, which I have here in my lab, and the other one to my laptop, and let's see what that brings. Great, so let's do the same test here. Just copy that file. Hello. Copy and paste it onto the desktop. And that goes up to 35 megabytes per second. So that's what, roughly 400 megabits? That goes a bit down. 300, 400 megabits. That is really, really good. But that is, I would say, the maximum, the top maximum that you can get under realistic conditions. Cool, so this test went up to close to 400 megabits. Not bad at all. You remember that I told you in the beginning that extension cords were bad, right? I ran the test with 2 wall outlets wired with rigid cable that were roughly 10 to 20 feet apart from each other and could get to 450 megabits per second. Please don't take me wrong. I'm not saying that the vendor is lying or that you could not get to a gigabit. I am sure that under optimized conditions, we would get there. All that I'm saying is that under real life conditions, it will be very difficult to reach those transmission rates. Have you made a different experience? I would love to hear from you. Please do leave me a comment. Guys, that concludes today's episode. In the next episode, we will look at how we can extend our Wi-Fi coverage with an additional access point. And in a further future episode, we will add an uninterruptible power supply to the network, a UPS, and see how to size it. Until then, many thanks for liking, subscribing, and of course, thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye for now.